here to present the Video Vanguard Award, one of the founding members of Public Enemy, Chuck D.
What's up? And good evening, ladies and gentlemen. What you just seen was a good moment for rap music, and I'm gonna talk a little bit about it, all right? In the early 1980s, the infectious style of rhythm and rhyme caught fever from the boogie-down Bronx to the New York metropolitan area, across the country and to the world. At the tail end of disco and punk as we knew it, were hybrid along with other sounds into the absorbing style of hip-hop. Picture 1983 and the onslaught of rappers, MCs, DJs, and new recording artists, Africa Bambaataa, Kool Herc, Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five, Treacherous Three, Sugar Hill Gang, and a brand new Run DMC. In those days, hip hop was truly from the streets, and everybody rapping was black. All of a sudden, these three punk rock white kids, there was no politically correct term for them back in the day, transcended their style and crossed it into hip hop with the shock of Jackie Robinson in reverse. MCA, Mike D, the King of Rock, ventured into a brave new world, a dark continent of this thing called rap music, fighting for their right and your right to party and rhyming across America and the world, accused of illing, stealing, and being wannabes, but eventually gaining respect in the school of hard knocks, and at the same time expanding and giving the music the diversity that it claims today. I'm proof of that. They helped me get put on, and I was on their first tour, License of Ill Tour, 1987. Well, it's 15 years later, and the Beastie Boys, in the long run, it proved they made the music grow and music grow, and they've grown as well, putting humanitarian words and actions together to make us all grow as well. I could go on and on to the break of dawn about the Beastie Boys and telling you to visit Paul's Boutique while giving you a license to ill communication and telling you to check your head until you say, hello, nasty. They say a picture's worth a thousand words. So let's check out the pictures, y'all.
The only reason that we haven't done a video yet is because as soon as we do, they're gonna have to change it from MTV to BCTV.
Well, straight up real props come from me and the crew, and MTV is pleased to honor, ladies and gentlemen, the Beastie Boys.
What's up? Yo, just real quick, we'd like to thank all our friends and all the people who worked really, thank you. All the people who worked really hard with us on these videos, producers, art directors, all the directors, Spike, Tammy D, Hornblower, anybody we didn't mention, like all our friends who just came together and made like these videos a reality and were able to listen to us. And not think we are crazy, but actually make them a reality. Thank you.
Yeah, in addition to thanking everybody that's worked on all the videos and all the people that have worked with us over the years, it's kind of a rare opportunity that one gets to speak to this many people at once. So if you guys will forgive me, I just wanted to speak my mind on a couple things. And I think it was a real mistake that the U.S. chose to fire missiles into the Middle East. I think that was a huge mistake. And I think that it's very important that the United States start to look towards nonviolent means of resolving conflicts. Because if we, hold on, give me one second here. Because if we, those bombings that took place in the Middle East were thought of as a retaliation by the terrorists. And if we thought of what we did as retaliation, certainly we're gonna find more retaliation from people in the Middle East. From terrorists specifically, I should say, because most Middle Eastern people are not terrorists. And I think that's another thing that America really needs to think about is our racism that comes from the United States towards Muslim people and towards Arabic people. And that's something that has to stop. And the United States has to start respecting people from the Middle East in order to find a solution to the problem that's been building up over many years. So I thank everyone for your patience and letting me speak my mind on that. And also mad respect to Chuck D and to everyone in the old school of hip hop who built all hip hop over the many years it took to be built. Thank you.
I'd like to say, I love you, Mom. I love you, Dave Skilkin.
Ladies and gentlemen.